Thank you. It's a pleasure to be with all of you in this third in a series of regional forums. And as Gerald said, we imagine four, and they're beginning to grow because lots of regions want to add their voice. And each forum, we're trying to explore a somewhat different aspect to hear stories about what the humanities mean to cultural and intellectual life and to the life of our young people and our older citizens, and why this is something that we have to create a more a coherent voice for continually. We all know what the humanities are in some ways. I mean, a really good strict definition, perhaps not, but we know that it's everything we do. It's thinking and writing and reading, and it's what we do when we're in line on a grocery worrying about what's going on at home, and it's what helps to at other ends to inform choices we make as a nation, how civil we are as a society, what our aspirations are for ourselves and for our neighbors. And so to imagine America not valuing the humanities is a very impoverished vision of America. I'm so grateful to Gerald Early and his colleagues on his staff for organizing this distinguished group of participants. Gerald is a valued member of the commission, and you know he's also a professor of modern letters and director of the Center for the Humanities at WashU. He also serves as chair of the Academy's Council. The American Academy was created in 1780, and we feel very honored that Gerald is taking the time to really give leadership to the intellectual goals that the Academy embraces. And so thank you for that. I also want to thank the Missouri History Society for hosting this meeting. The Academy decided to form this commission out of a sense that there was great deal more understanding and coherence to the arguments made for science, technology, engineering, and math, known as the STEM disciplines, and that we all in the Academy feel those are deeply important parts of the education, competitiveness, and future of our nation. But at the same time, it's very important for there to be a clear recognition that the other disciplines, the humanities and social sciences, and in the humanities I also embrace the arts, be paid more attention to, and that we give more national voice to what we do in these disciplines and professions, as well as in our daily life. Drawing on long-standing ties with colleges, universities, libraries, state councils, museums, government agencies, and business, the commission is examining the state of research, education from kindergarten to graduate school, and the importance of the humanities and social sciences for our public life, for our security, for our global competitiveness. The commission was charged to meet those goals by a bipartisan, it's nice to talk about a bipartisan group today in the middle of this election season, of Congress, including Senators Lamar Alexander and Mark Warner, and Representatives David Price and Tom Petri. And they asked us to answer basic questions about why the nation needs these disciplines from K through continuing education. And we will make preliminary recommendations early next year in a report that will complement the National Research Council's charge to do the same thing for science. So the scientific community has often been better organized at making these arguments. Often when the humanities community comes together, they begin to say, oh, what will we say? And I find these forums very important because what you say really is the message that we want to share with our leaders. It will give our commission, will use the testimony on the tape, some of the things you say, as Gerald suggested, in the final report. And ongoing, and we even may make some kind of a video out of this series of commission reports so that we can send it out over the web and share it with our own colleagues. The conversation this morning, then, will be a very important part of how we communicate the importance of these disciplines to our life. The American Academy, we didn't say much about it, I will say, was founded in 1780 during the American Revolution. The Scholar Patriots, it was an institution of the Enlightenment, and it was very dedicated to, in its earliest papers, practical, useful knowledge. The founders of the Academy thought that this nation would not be able to compete, even if it won the war, and that wasn't clear to them at the moment, without a great dedication to public education, to knowledge among all peoples, both scientific, practical scientific knowledge, and knowledge of language and other peoples and history. And so it's in that regard that we became known as the Academy of Arts and Sciences. Adams wrote, "Liberty cannot be preserved without general knowledge among the people," unquote. He would be impressed, I am sure, by the panelists assembled here today, all of you dedicated to that very same act of spreading general knowledge among the people. He would, I think, have been enthusiastic for our efforts, although we look quite different from the group that might have been assembled or was assembled at the earliest meetings of the Academy. So you're the heirs to Thomas Jefferson and Benjamin Franklin, or we are the heirs to them. They were our founders, and it's in that context that this commission was created. And so I'd like to turn the program back to you, and I thank you all for joining us in this effort.